Whoa! Oh.
This music doesn't fit this background at all.
What's going on?
Oh, it's a nice day here in Soviet Russia.
Oh, okay.
Ah, yes. My great journey. So today we're going to be playing some more Super Mario Collection. I am at like World B or so of the Lost Levels, the Japanese version of Mario All-Stars.
Are you sure you're in B?
I thought so. I think we beat A because A is like the really easy ones. And then B...
9 was the real easy ones.
Oh, you're right.
Yep. Right, I think we're in A2.
Yeah. Okay, so today we had a meeting with Tony, our book designer guy. And we talked about like the 80 projects that we have going on.
Literally 80. It's too many.
Yeah, it's really crazy. So anyway, here's for the first time ever, here's like a preview. It's like the wrong color because the printer died.
So this is
the wrong color and it's not final. But here's what the book that we're working on is going to look like.
Oh, good. It's a little transparent.
Yeah, that this is a really crazy printer.
It's going to be about that size.
Yeah, something around this. It's going to look like this. This is going to be a really bright orange. Wow, that's cool.
Brighter than that.
It's going to be really bright. It's like burn your eyes bright. And here's a printout of how thick it is. Oh, and here's the back. Or that's like the back page. And also, this is still very early on, but here's a quick look at the Nina book.
Look, you call it I'm Stuck in a Video Game.
Yeah, I'm Stuck in a Video Game book.
This is the extra content part of the book.
Yeah, we're working on the extra content. So this is the book that was made by the producer of Game Center CX.
Yep.
And Nina Matsumoto did the art and translation and localization for it. And Legends of Localization has a little bit of some involvement with this project.
So. I produced it.
Yep. And I asked some questions.
Let me see the book again.
Which one?
The GCCX. Let me see. Because in the back, see, you're not just going to get a children's book. You're also going to get...
Yeah, I didn't know how much you wanted to show off at the time.
Well, like, we said we'd show the extra or just, like...
So you're going to get to see, like, the localization process, and you're going to get to see the full Japanese book, too.
We've got the Japanese version in the back, and also we've got, like, a little interview with Khan and Nina and Tony about how do you do all this.
So our version is going to be way better than the Japanese version.
Yeah, Khan.
That's right, for the first time.
You're great. This is American humor. Don't worry.
Yeah.
we like you a lot.
All right. So I was talking with Tony. We were looking at the Mario RPG stuff I've been working on, and I want him to help like design it a little better so it doesn't look like Mado designed the sidebar for Mario RPG.
Like your 2005 website that somebody commented on.
Yeah, I have a really bad design sense. So so next week, I don't think we're going to do the Mario RPG. But it's pretty close to being ready to go. I want to make sure it looks good, though. So next week, we're probably going to do some more Mario Collection, or we'll play something.
Mario 3.
Mario 3, yeah. So I'm thinking next week we'll probably do Mario 3.
Get some raccoon ears.
Let's see, what else? Oh, so today we're going to be doing Mario Collection, the Lost Levels. And right before, like literally like 2 minutes ago, I decided like, you know what? If this gets annoying and I get tired of it, I programmed a thing in that every time I die, it'll slowly corrupt RAM. So the game could just start doing crazy things the more and more I die.
Oh.
So maybe we can do that after I get frustrated enough.
I thought we were just going to switch to a new game, but we're going to take this to the next level.
You know, it's Friday. We got to do something special for Friday. So here we go. Let me put the game up, because that one day I forgot to put the game up.
Oh no, it's a sad song. Turn this off.
I believe we're still hooked into my channel.
Okay.
I'm getting some dry throat here.
Mario looks at you sometimes. He's a creep. Bowser has fire eyes.
So wait, that bomb's always been there.
But his thing lit up.
Oh, okay.
I thought he appeared, but it was just his thing looking, lighting up. Lit up. He's lit.
So the RAM corruption thing is not active at the moment. I was testing it here in Mario 1.
Okay.
We
are in B? What?
I know, I'm making sure that I am doing it from the right
There's spot. Mega Man.
Mega Man. All right, we're doing Mario. Oh, we're at 80 lives. Okay, I think we're going to do well.
Wow. All
right, we need a B1 lyrics.
B17 Bomber. How's that?
Oh, Is this following us?
I don't think so. Are we still on the cosmos?
Oh, crap, we might be.
That's okay.
All right. Yeah, we're still in the cosmos.
I didn't know the cosmos was still going.
Maybe it's not.
So... yeah, Outspur, we're not sure anymore. Hello, traveling through Aldra. Where are you? Oh, the mic. The mic was in
Mike
the way.
Mike and Ike.
So today is Reed's birthday.
Oh, I didn't know that.
He doesn't like people to know.
Yeah, same with me.
But Tony went to CVS and bought a bunch of Easter candy on clearance.
Oh, man.
And we refilled all of the plastic Easter eggs and rehid them everywhere. And only Reed can find eggs today. After that, it's open season. So only Reed gets all the candy today. Oh, no!
Oh, you...
is Reed an eagle? Happy birthday.
Those bastard blocks.
If I asked him that, he'd be like, what are you talking about? And then I'd have to explain Funky Fantasy 4, and then I would just walk away.
Yeah, the amount of projects I have planned is insane. Nope.
Kevin Chai, you got here too late. Those are Reed's candies. Barf it up and give it to him.
What, he stole some of Reed's candy? Oh, that means he has to buy like twice as much. He has to buy a full bag for every piece. That's Fangamer law. Get out of here.
Have we seen... no, we stopped at the beginning of this level, right?
Yeah, I didn't do it at all.
Oh, snap! That was kind of easy.
We were talking about Reed, that's why.
Oh. The power of Reed, man.
Yep.
1 year, a couple years ago when Reed turned 30...
oh, he's 30.
First of all, I had to text Camille to make sure, is it his birthday today and is he 30? Because he doesn't tell anybody. We got Magpie's Pizzas. And
we need to do that again.
I found out his favorite topping is apparently sausage. So I asked them to write the letters 30 and sausage on the pizza, and they did. And he was surprised.
With the numbers or the letters? Because the letters numbers. Would be really impressive.
The numbers.
Oh, what is this level? This is a weird level. So I got my Japanese copy of Breath of the Wild in, like, yesterday, I think it was.
Yeah.
And so I'm probably going to start playing it next week.
Yeah. I haven't been taking as many screenshots as I should. Because I didn't know your plan when I first started playing.
So that means you can play some more.
Did I just restart the game?
You can do a different account, right?
Yeah, I can. All right, so I'll just start screenshotting from here.
And then, like, when you go back, yeah.
Yeah, I'll do a different account. Alec, you don't have to watch Tengai Makyo if you don't want to.
Wait, what? Who would want to watch that?
Alexius? Alexicticus?
No, Tengai Makyo. I liked all the chat we had, and we filled the time with fun. And it was also cool, like, trying to figure out how we would localize certain things.
Yes. But also,
I think a cat snoring.
Yeah, Zooey snoring.
That's cute. I like that she likes Tony.
Zooey likes nobody but us and Tony. Oh, be careful, it'll come off the string. No!
I wonder if that's being picked up on the stream.
This string is pink.
Don't be evil.
I would have expected that to be a purple mushroom.
Uh-oh.
You're alright. Oh.
Uh-oh. What the heck?
Oh, that's the background?
No!
Oh, no!
Oh, I might live.
You're okay, you're okay.
See, that's why it's good to do start. No! Uh-oh.
You have to jump on a bullet?
Nope.
Aww.
That's okay. I got my life back. Good life.
Mado, do you think you could do any impressions of the Simpsons characters?
No. I'm not a good impression guy. I haven't even figured out my own voice.
I like your Michael Jackson voice.
Woohoo!
No, that wasn't it.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's when it changes in the middle of talking.
Yeah, I don't have a wide range of voices.
No! I'm very upset at what happened at Stargate Atlantis last night.
Uh-oh, we're already to the Stargates.
Well, I was thinking about it all day, like, holy crap. That was like a chess game played by a chess master. That thing that the Wraith did.
So who's better, Picard or General Hammond?
General Hammond.
Okay.
Because he says good. Good.
He's balder and fatter.
Good, yep. He's balder and fatter, and he has a better personality.
Kind of reminds me of Reed.
General Hammond?
Where he's just like, do it.
Do it. That's like half of what General Hammond says. Just do it all the time. Whatever. I don't care that you're putting the lives of this entire world at stake. Do it. But most of the time, they are saving the world.
No. It's this again.
It's tough to beat Sir Patrick Stewart in the baldness department.
I gotta figure out what to do about that.
I did not understand the ice bucket challenge until like many years later. I realized it was to raise awareness for ALS, and I wondered, how does dumping ice on your head do that? Still don't know. But hey.
No.
I know it's called ALS now instead of Lou Gehrig's disease. Isn't that what ALS is?
Whenever I think of ALS, I think of my coworker. Because that's her initials.
Oh.
I became aware of my coworker.
Oh. It did something. They did it so it would go viral and people would donate to ALS research. Alright.
That totally hit his head even though I ducked. That's so weird.
It just grazed his hat. He's fine.
Alright, we're up here. Oh no. What more is there? Oh, I can make that.
Really?
Oh, very close. I probably could have. Alright.
Oh, was it?
It's not as bad as a bunch of other levels from like 2 days ago.
It's good, Bahamut. I wish I didn't have any either.
Eyes?
Social media accounts. Oh. I've gotten tired of them. Whoa! We're doing good today. We are down here. We're okay. Whoa! We're still okay.
Don't make me do that turtle jump. I don't even know what's over there.
A bullet jump now.
No, the bullet jumps don't give me any height.
Oh, really?
That red one's gonna come get me. Oh, you need to get out of here. Bye. Oh my god.
Is it down there?
Is it going to make me go down there? Let me see what's over there. We're synchronized there.
Yeah. Got a couple fireworks there. I should put on my fireworks shirt.
Uh-oh. Oh. Don't go down there.
Into the spaghetti sauce. This level always makes me want spaghetti.
It looks too red.
It's delicious. Mr. Tinda has seen this level before.
Oh.
Localize that joke.
I probably could. And, there's a phrase, you know how like we have the phrase piece of cake?
Mm-hmm.
That one would seem hard, but there's a phrase that's similar in Japanese, which translates to before breakfast.
Oh.
You know, like you could do that before breakfast because it's so easy. So that's really good because they're both food related.
All right. So that episode in Stargate we saw last night, it's possible.
So sometimes if you know your idioms, there's some good ones you can do. Oh, it's a maze.
Is it? How do you know?
I don't know. It felt like one. Matt used to have a site called Before Breakfast.
I always wondered what that meant. This is feeling mazy.
I'm not giving any hints this time.
Unless it's not a maze and it's just... You just have to go. They're tricking you.
Oh, no.
Oh, nice. Hello, Star Tofu. I'm sorry you are sick today. But hey, you can join us. Oh, no.
I bet it stinks under there.
Ew. AGDQ abused the save system by warping from world A to C and then using the save function to go back to B4 to warp to D.
What the heck?
I don't know. Ooh, it's pretty! Are those clouds in the distance here?
I don't know.
Mountains or something. They look like clouds.
Did Arino ever play these secret levels?
Man, I just can't remember. So I think you asked the other day.
So for the disk system, it's really evil. Like, so the disk system doesn't save. It doesn't save. It saves if you've beaten the game, and I think it saves your high score. And I think if you can beat the game 8 times, you have to do it in one sitting, then you can do these levels.
I hate Mario 2. I hate Japanese Mario 2.
I don't know what they could do to make it even worse, you know?
That is ridiculous.
Oh, I know what they could do to make it worse. Up is jump.
That is a ridiculous amount of things you have to do just to see these levels.
Oh, that didn't work.
It's me. That didn't work either. Sorry.
Yeah, I made all that, and then I just run into, like, enemy number 2. Yeah, that's weird.
I might get a bike.
What? That was random.
Well, I've been thinking about it for a while. There's this bike loop kind of close by. I thought, it takes you to all the parks.
Oh, that one was faster. That was neat.
There's a loop around town that takes you to all the parks. My bike to a park. I don't think I want a magical bike.
The best. So, Paul, you were playing some more Vroom right before the stream?
Yep.
Is there a reason?
I need to 100% it.
Did you find anything new? I heard you laughing.
Yes, I was, we did the room gallery update yesterday, or the day before.
It's been making the rounds on the news. I made Polygon, Kotaku, a bunch of international sites.
Yeah, but, let's see. When I was, going through those screenshots, I noticed a bunch of, phrases from version 1.0 that didn't seem to have a 1.1 counterpart. Mm-hmm. But as I was playing tonight, or just now, I found those 1.1 counterparts.
Are they different?
They're different. So, remember, I'm cute, and I'm more cute than you. I found the counterpart to that in 1.1.
Is it good?
It's actual proper English.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm cuter than you.
Oh.
Yeah, so we might do an update to the gallery eventually. Yeah. I got screenshots with the, Switch screenshot. I don't know how good they are.
The idea with the galleries is that we will update them, all the galleries.
Oh. The thing that I was really laughing at is I got stuck between a building. So I was trying to get out, and then the camera moved really close to my pink magical girl, and she was just, staring up at nothing, and she looked really stupid, so that's what I was laughing at. I got a lot of screenshots of that. Oh.
I need a way around. It's too... Oh, I saw a Hammer Brother there.
The FDS version was released on the US Virtual Console unchanged for some reason.
That is pretty evil.
Mido should make a passport for the English version of Room based on the Japanese text, then maybe we can understand it.
I am kind of curious to see what the Japanese text is like. I'm sure it's pretty straightforward.
Couldn't we?
Yeah, there's probably a way. I think we have to change the language of our Switch.
Mm.
This part sucks.
I am, I hope Poisoft doesn't see all this coverage and thinks that we're making fun of them, though.
Well, we can still offer to help them if we want to.
I want to say, hey, we'll do, a real translation of Room for you. But, keep your great translation as an option.
Yeah, an optional. Oh.
Your charming translation. Do they have a word for charming?
Probably.
You use that all the time when talking to them.
I wonder if I can make that.
8-3.
What about 8-3?
Oh, lost levels. I was going to say 8-2 was a lot harder than 8-3, but that was in the original. Switch the console. We need to switch the console language settings. Middle, I really like Red Letter Media.
Yep.
What's your favorite Red Letter Media thing?
It's hard to say, but I really liked Ghostbusters Review.
No, like show, segment.
Oh, crap. Probably Wheel the Worst.
Me too. Plinketto is kind of dumb.
Yeah.
Because it always seems to go where you put it. Mm-hmm. I think they need to redo the nails. But it's such a pain in the butt. I don't blame them if they don't. Hey, the Yada.
Alright, I don't know how to do this.
Red Letter Media likes me back? What does that mean?
I was trying to go across rather than up this time, but I feel like there's something I'm missing there.
Oh!
Hmm.
Are you serious? We can play the American Breath of the Wild in Japanese.
Really?
But we bought the Japanese version.
It's okay. It's good to have it. So
the box back is different.
Yeah, so you could do that with, what is it, Smash Brothers Melee? I bought the Japanese version first, and the Japanese version has an English option.
Weird.
But there are actually differences between it and the American version.
Hey, Eric Solar.
So it's possible it's the same deal.
What is Red Letter Media?
It's a bunch of internet nerds. They sit around and are grumps.
Wait now. You might know them best from their, 70-minute-long review of Phantom Menace, and then the whole rest of the original trilogy. Or I should say the prequels. But they have a lot of other shows that they do. RedLetterMedia.com.
Whoa! What? What? You guys saw that. What the heck was that? The game just decided. I was like, no.
The voice acting is determined by the system language. First party Switch games have all languages built into them based on system region. This also applies to third party games like Disgaea 5. And it's part of the reason Nintendo's push for region-free Switch. It's pretty good. We're new to this region-free stuff. They haven't done that in like a decade plus.
That was some evil stuff that game pulled on me there.
Oops, I missed it.
I jumped on a beetle and it killed me. I jumped on it.
Oh, we've been in C. What am I thinking of?
Alright, that beetle needs a name. Cheetle.
Cheetle? Don. Mr. Cheetle. Mr. Cheezle. Mr. Cheezle. Do you know who Mr. Cheezle is? Yes, you do!
Somebody made up.
No, he's from Grandma's Boy. Kevin Nealon.
Is that his name?
It's the guy they work for, Mr. Cheezle.
I don't know names. You know that.
But it's such a weird name.
All I remember is that he always doing yoga, and then he would talk about, like, that's so Miyamoto.
Yeah, see? Mr. Cheezle. He's cheesy.
You guys need to watch Grandma's Boy. We need to watch it. We haven't watched it in about a year. Okay. I'm gonna let him come back first. Bye.
I don't know if 2.75 million Switches is impressive. I don't know.
All right, here's
I don't know these consoles.
Here's Cheetle.
What did Cheetle do?
I jumped on him and he killed me.
Oh.
He broke the game's rules.
They do that sometimes.
Here's Miyamoto again. Hey, is that the chat back here? This is you guys. Tag yourself.
Wait a minute. What is this? Where's Ultros? Is this Ultros?
You're Ultros.
Oh, am me?
Yeah.
Am me.
No. Oh, okay.
Oh, Ultima Spark. They've never actually reached 9-1 on their own.
What the heck?
I don't blame you, because it's tough to get here. Tough to get to 9. My phone isn't here. It's somewhere else.
President's calling.
It just smacked into your bum and you died.
I'm trying to do the gotta go fast method there. Ah. Alright, this is the dying level.
What's your favorite Sonic game?
I don't have one.
Pick one.
I don't really have one because I haven't played too many. Like, I used to play some when you come home. Remember that? But I don't remember what games those were. What number?
I'm pretty sure it was 1.
Okay, yeah, it's probably trying to go in order. I feel like I needed to at some point.
2, 3, and Knuckles.
3 and Knuckles?
There's Sonic 3 and Knuckles. I don't know how it's one game. Because I recall Sonic 3 and then Sonic and Knuckles.
Isn't that where you stick the thing on it?
I don't know. I was not a hip kid, so I don't know how to do that. But apparently that's a thing. Sonic 3D Blast. I'm just going to say that's your favorite, Wang Fo, because you just said it. It's the truth. Cheetle was reborn as that cheap cheap.
What the crap? This is a Mario Maker level that I would have made.
Sonic and Knuckles could let you lock another cart into that, and doing that you could play Sonic 3 and Knuckles. But how does that change the game? Could you, like, lock Sonic 1 into that? Favorite Sonic game is the 2011 version of Sonic CD.
What the heck?
Oh! Sonic 3 and Sonic and Knuckles were originally one game. They had to split it in half due to not being able to afford to make it all on a single cartridge and running out of money.
Someone got a promotion for saying, hey, let's make it two games.
Sonic 3 is like part one of Sonic and Knuckles. That is so interesting. Holy crap. Yeah, my favorite is Sonic 06. But really, really my favorite is 1.
I started to stutter there. That's the way to go.
Hello, tired teddy bear. It is brutal. You could put Sonic 1 into Sonic and Knuckles, but it would just let you play the Sonic 3 Blue Sphere bonus game.
That one jump.
You're doing all right.
I'm gonna have to sell my organs to beat this level.
Which organ would you sell?
My ear. Just one.
Is that an organ?
I think.
How about the Sonic Dreams collection? I forgot what
so
that was.
So many Sonic games, yeah.
Yeah.
Did they ever do a tie-in with Sonic, fast food?
I'm sure.
They should have.
But they probably didn't use the gotta go fast thing, like, the speed. Maybe they did.
I need to go back to third grade.
Looking at this makes me glad that we got Super Mario Bros. USA instead, says Tired Teddy Bear. Your name's making me sleepy. Dominator would sell their church organ. Amethyst Frost would sell their pancreas. Bahamut still has their appendix. Me too.
No, I was trying to overcompensate there.
I don't think third graders could do this. Do you think they'll ever go back? Like, I know they did Sonic Generations and they did something else. You okay?
Yeah.
Do you think they would ever go back to the 2D sprite Sonic for a new game?
They are.
What?
It's being worked on. I forget the name of it.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
God, I don't keep up
with
gaming
It has a
news.
Bunch of original related people.
Well then, that's the one I'm going to play.
I need to name this jump.
Meatball has never played these bonus levels because they only own the Famicom Disk System version.
You can do it.
Sonic Mania is a sprite-based 2D Sonic made by the guy who ported Sonic 1 and 2 to Android.
And Sonic Onion Rings? I mean, that's perfect. Do they serve chili dogs at Sonic?
They have to have sold chili dogs. Oh my god, I didn't make the Sonic connection with Sonic. I was actually thinking of Checkers and their chili dogs. And it has, like, you know, the racing flag type of thing. Luckylite would sell Augsburg's organs. Sonic Mania comes out a little bit later this year.
Everyone's doing illegal stuff here.
What system is Sonic Mania on?
It's probably everything. No, I made it. Now what?
Does anyone here prefer this to Mario USA? I was never a fan of Mario 2, though, because I played it when 3 was already out, so I was like, I'd rather play 3.
So this is a green one. What does that mean?
I don't know.
Does that mean it's fake?
Try it.
Look at them.
Oh, oh, that kind.
All right, I'm. I will use you, friend.
Oh, switch included? All right.
I'll go no. for the switch. Oh my god, I think I would need that.
Mario USA is Amethyst Frost's favorite of the four. Sonic Forces, basically Generations 2, is coming out later.
I can't keep track of everything. No. It's so crazy.
I'll get Sonic Mighty Switch Force, whatever the one's coming on the Switch.
When are they going to do a Sonic? Oh, I screwed up. Yeah, when are they going to do a Sonic, I screwed up. When are they going to do like a Sonic Warriors? Because they're doing the Warriors everything these days.
Like, he has a sword?
Yeah.
Didn't they do that in...
Well, you know, with, like, Zelda... What? With, like, Zelda...
Oh, Hyrule Warriors type of thing. Yeah, yeah.
You know, they got the One Piece. Like, they're doing something else. I forget.
So, Wang Fo says, Mario USA did a lot more for the series and introduced a lot of new enemies and characters that live
That's
on
true.
Today.
That's true, yeah.
Lost Levels introduced nothing but pain. Lost Levels introduced a super jumping board, correct?
So while working on the Mario book, I keep running into a lot of coverage for Mario 2. And I haven't been paying attention to it because, you know, it's not relevant to the book. But I want to go check it out because it seems like they're really celebrating it and really hyping it up beforehand, too.
Japanese Mario 2?
I want to see how it did in the, you know, the popularity and things. See what review it got. We probably have a magazine that has that.
What year did it come out?
80? No, it was the year after Mario 1, so...
Oh, 86. Holy cow, I don't know if we have a magazine that old.
We do. We got a couple. We're in Sea Cheap.
Dragon Quest Heroes?
Oh yeah, that's right. There's already working on a 2 of that, I think.
Wait, is that like a Hyrule Warriors?
Yeah.
What system? I want it.
Everything, probably.
That can probably be the only Dragon Quest I finish. I'm very interested in Dragon Quest, but mostly...
The slimes.
Because of the enemies. Not just the slimes, just the cool enemies. That was a big reason why I wanted to get all the other Tales games, because in Tales of Vesperia's enemies were really cute and interesting.
I don't know what to do about this. This is insane.
It'll come out on the Switch? Mm-hmm. Mario Warriors exists in an FF1 hack.
Oh no. Okay.
Eventually Switch gets Dragon Quest Heroes 1 and 2. Cool. Switch is my favorite console.
Is it?
Because I can sit down like this and I can hold it. Oops.
Oh.
I can hold it with my knees and then use the Pro Controller like that and just sit like this and play the game.
I like how you're not playing it the way they intended.
Nope.
Sorry, everyone with ears.
I'm sorry.
You should have donated your ears.
I should draw a picture of how I play the Switch. Sorry. Good luck with C3. Remember this level? Now it has wind. And the Locky 2. Switch is the best part of the Wii U. Are you sure the Wii U could do exactly what the Switch does in that you could, I got scared. That you could just, like... I know it had the screen where you could take wherever you wanted, but, like, it didn't have the console in the screen like the Switch does. I don't know how the Wii U screen thingy works, because I never played it that way. I never played it much at all.
Man, look at him running away.
Even Locky 2 can't handle this.
I remember this. No!
Oh, no! The next level, C4, is explosive.
I was going for it.
I want to look into Dragon Quest monsters? Okay.
That's another game with like 80 games that I can't keep track of. I prefer my good old Earthbound with the few games that didn't come out.
The hardest part of this level on the FDS version is that Lakitu can cause the springboards not to spawn.
Oh my god.
Rendering the level impossible. The gamepad will let you play without a TV for most games, but you couldn't get terribly far from the console. Okay. Alright, okay. So that was all it did. In that case, the Switch is so much better. Because I can just take it anywhere.
No, that's what people would do with the Wii U. They would always say that's the big selling point.
But did you just hear what people said?
I know. People still did it.
You can't go far from the console.
People would talk about taking it into the bathroom.
Well, that's not far.
Into the bedroom. I think some people I know would take it into the bathtub.
But, I mean, like, Ryan Novak played it on the airplane. Like, that kind of stuff.
What, the Switch?
Yeah. Like, it's a real console that you can take handheld. So, that's what's really cool about it. Nintendo, hire me to talk about your Switch. Because I have hated your consoles since the Wii. And here I am, loving the Switch.
What about the new 2DS XL?
That wasn't a joke?
No, but I forget his name, his full name. It's pretty crazy.
Dragon Quest Monsters is Pokemon, but with Dragon Quest. Ooh. So many games won't let you play on the gamepad like Splatoon.
It's so weird. It's like, why even have the option, you know?
Yeah.
Same with the Switch's controllers. No.
Oh.
That was a good one.
So there's a Japanese eShop demo. That's cool. Of DQ Heroes 1 and 2. The new 2DS XL and Knuckles. The Joy-Cons are a hot piece of mess. Oh, I agree. I had to go buy a Pro Controller. And now I really like the Switch.
What?
Huh?
That was weird. I'm not gonna make it.
The Wii was okay. But the last good Nintendo console that I really liked was the GameCube. And my favorite handheld Nintendo console for a long time was just the regular old DS. And the 3DS is pretty cool. But I think still the DS.
That's another system where they stopped doing the gimmick after it got annoying. Yes, take that, you dumb cloud. No. Alright, we're gonna need to do something besides the Cosmo soon.
Okay. Let me see who's streaming. No, none of my people I follow are streaming, which is like 4 people. The Cool Gaming Bros last played Monopoly Family Fun Pack? What the heck is going on in that channel? What are the hidden gems of the Wii, Wangfo?
Cooking Mama.
Oh yeah, Summit 1G. We can go into that guy's stream. What? Might get my tarot read. Does it have anything to do with, like, zodiac? I'm a Cancer. It's that one that looks like a Muppet.
What the heck? Oh no. What? I remember this part. No!
No!
Ooh, 180,000 exactly.
Tie into S2L softener. He's probably streaming Puyo Tetris. Xenoblade Chronicles was a hidden gem. Muramasa, the Demon Blade. Didn't we get...
No, you liked it, though. You liked the graphics. You wanted to play it.
I wanted to play it. No More Heroes.
That's something I always meant to play. I just never got it.
Dokapone Kingdom, Arkrise Fantasia, Bit Trip series, and Muramasa. Bit Trip is the best Wii game. I haven't played that. Fishing Resort on Wii is really good, no joke. I believe you.
It's okay.
Freaking love.
It's Friday.
Fishing games. Or like...
It's effing Friday.
It's effing Friday. A Boy in His Blob? Little King's Story. I forgot where I was.
Yeah. Yeah, I swore during our meeting today and Tony didn't bat an eye.
Well, Tony swears all the time.
I know.
It's the rest of Fangamer you gotta worry about.
Yeah, we're the cool...
Look at all these cocoa pebbles flying through the air.
Oh, I hate cocoa pebbles in the air.
Uh-oh, police sirens started going off. Oh, the Metroid Prime Trilogy. That's right, Blaze 4.
Isn't that really expensive, though?
Yeah, and remember, it was really not expensive when it first came out, and I thought about getting it, and I didn't.
I had to go see him in the hospital. All right. We need some help.
Oh, boy. S was it?
All right, Summit. So we're at 513.
Summit 1G.
If things get too bad, we'll just start doing the crazy time. Oops. Oh, that's right. Okay. It is called what? Summit what?
1G.
All right. Here we go. We're doing so good today. My momentum's gone.
Whoa! Oh,
that was like turbo death.
Oh, no!
I was trying to do 100% luck too. Whoever made this level, I hope you're dead.
They really liked Cocoa Krispies and Middle. That's insensitive.
I mean, look how many times I died. Oh. Isn't this the game where you can get the mushroom if it's falling right at the edge and you go to the opposite edge vertically? So I wonder what coordinate it thinks I'm at right now.
Xkeeper says, BMF and I had a version of this that forcibly swapped player 1 and player 2 control after every death and allowed switching between Mario and Luigi at will. It was fun, but it didn't make this game any easier.
So if you can beat 8-4 in Mario 1, you can, you know, get a job at Fangamer.
No, you can get a job in Nintendo.
Oh, yeah. And then if you can beat... D4 of this.
Yeah.
Then you can work at Nintendo Japan.
Aha. Would you want to?
I don't know. Oh. I was hasty there. I knew what I was doing. Alright, Summit Hut. We need your lives.
Summit Hut.
Uh-oh.
Look.
I wonder what's happening over there. I think we're still doing 1-for-1. I guess it makes sense if Summit Guy has a lot.
You have to be Ninja Gaiden to get a job at Fangamer? Oh, Lord. Well, I'm out.
It's okay. You're in there because of the marriage clause.
What? No. I'm my own person.
What the heck? I got points, though. That's all I care about.
Because a spiny came out of his butt at the last second. Lucklight beat D4 as a teen. Can they become a teen fan gamer employee? You can work for NOJ, or actually
NCL.
The end screen is a live job interview with Miyamoto. Oh my god, can you imagine? Just everyone, like, Miyamoto's asleep, and then, like, the screen comes on, he's like, and we're staring at him, he's like, oh, you beat D4? Alright, give me a second, I'll get up and get my coffee. Z suddenly knows English, because, you got to. You got to for that kind of stuff.
No! So if I ever make a really difficult game, I'm going to put a secret code word at the end, and then you say it to your employer.
Oh, yeah,
and then
yeah.
That's how you get the surefire in.
Did you know Starman.net did something like that with registration?
And then, like, and reading the rules? If you read the rules, then you can get, like, a free something or other.
It's a free avatar.
And then one person finally did it, like, 2 years later.
Yeah, for years, that was in the rules, and at the very end, it was like, if you read the rules, like, let whoever know, and you get a free avatar. 2 years later, someone, I think it was Yoshi Star, I remember them because that was the one who read the rules before clicking, yes, I read the rules. No, it started with a Y. I don't think it was Yoshi Star.
I lost count.
It's me. Gosh, only 10 lives, gosh. Maybe we should switch it to 5.
Yesterday we were getting a bunch.
Well, we were on the cosmos yesterday.
Yeah, that's true.
Man, these freaking things.
It's all of my weaknesses. No!
I'm pretty sure, Oxford, I'm mixing... I know there's a Yoshi Star who I've seen before on Twitch. Probably mixing them up with whoever claimed that avatar because their name started with a Y.
So, like, 10 years ago, everyone was saying YOLO, or maybe it was not 10 years ago. What is the current thing?
That Jingle all the way.
all the kids are saying these days that is annoying to the... old folks' homes. All right, get out of here.
There's something. There's always something. Oh, I know. This isn't like an annoying saying. It's just something that younger people tend to say a lot, I've noticed. For sure. Oh, yeah, for sure. Like, instead of, you know, when agreeing for something, you just say, for sure. Instead of, yeah. I've noticed that. Bay, lit, shook, emojis, woke.
Oh, emojis, yeah. Oh my god, that's gonna be... that's gonna be crazy in 20 years.
I don't know why...
why did they take off now and not, like... Because I remember when AOL had them.
Yeah.
And I remember reading about the emoticons. They were called
emoticons.
I guess there wasn't a poop one at the time.
No.
I think that's it. Someone's going to do a documentary, and they're going to document the poop. And I hope they're happy with themselves.
Froon just used a microscope emoji. Or I should say a Twitch icon. Bay got woke after we lit up some emojis. Bay. Yeah, that one gets on my nerves, because I don't even know what it's supposed to mean. I know what it means, but I don't know why. Bay caught me slipping. Oh man, I don't even know.
Remember in the 90s when like the Ebonics thing was going on, they were trying to teach it in schools and it was this big old controversy. Whatever happened to that?
Wait, Bay means before anyone else, as in you put this person before anyone else. Bay is a systems defense contractor. Wait. Oh, BAE. Bay system. BAE systems. I got it. Baywatch.
Aren't they making a movie of that?
Probably.
With The Rock in it? He's like in every movie now.
Probably.
I feel like he's a parody of real life now.
Oh boy. Don't read the chat. Doctor Who spoilers.
Oh. I forgot that existed. Did Doctor Who ever beat this game?
Doctor Who is not his name.
It's always kind of annoying when they try to stuff the Doctor Who into the script somehow. Like, Doctor Who?
Now, the first time I heard that joke, I don't know if it was a joke. It was like a serious time. It was like season 6 or 7 or something. It's like the eternal question.
Yeah.
Doctor Who.
Mm-hmm.
That's...
I mean, that was pretty okay.
Yeah, that was good. But I didn't know any... Man, that one episode with that girl who was basically Tumblr incarnate.
Oh, yeah. There was a couple of those.
Oh, boy. She was wearing the scarf. I have the scarf, too. His name is Dr. Whom?
Oh, Spiny. So that'd be a good cat name.
The dog... And St. Ostrich feels physical pain every time they say Doctor Who during an episode of Doctor Who. He lost his medical license. It's Mr. Who. Remember we were introducing Doctor Who to Jack and Jenna?
Oh, my God. Yeah.
And right. Jack forgot the name of the show, and I put a show on, and he's like, is this Mr. Who? No.
All right. So I told myself if I'm dying all the time at 6 o'clock, I'll probably go do... my crazy version of the game that I decided to make.
It is 6.
So, are people sick of this level?
I'm just talking about Doctor Who. And I know it used to be spelled Dr. Who, but I like the rules now that that's not his name.
No. Whoa.
Whoa, okay.
I couldn't even calculate that one. I'm dead now.
Sure are. Funky Mario Bros. Time.
So you guys want to do that? I mean, maybe I can beat the... If I can beat the level... Alright. Alright, to make it more fun, we're going to do the funky version.
Alright, alright. All right. 5-3-5-3-3 now.
Alright. Alright. I'm going to do some stuff here. Let me put on some musics for you.
Nostalgic is curious about what the RAM corruption will do.
Yeah. I didn't even test it. I did it like 2 minutes before we started streaming. Actually, I have it right now happening when I get a 1-up, and since that's not happening, we are going to do it.
Yeah, we haven't been getting legit 1-ups.
Scroll lock? What the heck? Alright, so... Alright, we'll do... 3 crazy stuffs per death.
Okay. I like looking at your programming there.
This is good music for this. I think so. But... Alright.
You can't...
If things get too crazy, we'll listen to other music.
You can't die on purpose.
No, I'm going to try to beat it. I'm going to try to beat it.
Yeah.
Just going to make it more fun now.
Yeah, yeah.
What if, like, I suddenly get super jump powers or something, you know?
You hit a save state.
All right, so every time I die, the memory is going to get corrupted a little bit more and more. And I did not test this, so I don't know what to expect. It could just crash the game.
Will there finally be pie making and blood selling?
Yeah, maybe. Meanwhile, we're getting extra lives. This is just the weird version that you'll never get anywhere else.
Chaos mode. I like it.
Well, that's a good phrase, yeah. mean, if they're going to be cheap, I'm going to be cheap, you know?
Cheap, cheap.
Yeah. What? Oh.
Okay, that was cheap. What changed?
It could be nothing. Like, things might get reinitialized, so it won't matter. It's just going to be... At some point, something weird will happen.
Okay.
Like, after a death. Oh. Whoa, that was cool. You see, as I was dying, I fell sideways.
Nope.
Because of the wind was still affecting them.
It's working.
Whoa!
Is it working?
It is, but you just won't know right away.
I don't know how these things work.
There's a lot of memory.
Yeah.
And so if it's going to do random, there's a good chance it'll hit nothing of importance.
Oh.
It's just random. I mean, I could make it do stuff.
No.
But it's possibly cumulative. Go away. Okay, no spines over there.
Do you think those flowers are made of blood?
Probably. My momentum. Summit's getting some good lives. No! So close.
What are some things that could happen?
Can't anticipate it. So we'll just find out as things happen.
So it's messing with the RAM and not the ROM?
Yeah, the RAM.
Okay. Program a version that randomly turns random cheat codes on and off.
That'd be cool. I know XKeeper has all kinds of stuff like that. Where you can even just type codes into the chat, or you can just type stuff into the chat to corrupt the current game running.
ZC230's in here and says, what did Mato do that's spawning all this weird discussion? I almost said corruption. Mato, I went to the farmer's market this morning,
mm-hmm.
and I bought from a stall called Larry's Vegetables.
Oh, did you get any of those Yum Breads?
No, that was the Saturday farmer's market.
Okay. That's the good one.
Yeah. And so I got squash and garlic and tomatoes and spinach.
Well, spinach is okay.
And cucumbers.
That's okay. Cucumbers are nice and have that refreshingness to them.
They're the small kinds that you don't have to, like, peel the skin because the skin isn't too tough. They're like Japanese cucumbers.
It's so weird. They have to sort of, like... learn where you are.
Yum bread sounds good.
That's how we talk normally.
The bread we got last week was apple rhubarb walnut bread. It was very good.
Yum bread's easier to say.
Zelda Chaos Mode affected things like gravity and friction.
Cool. Oh, I got farther than I ever got. My daring maneuver worked, and then my jump did not.
Can I try a life? Maybe I'll be the one who...
You'll be the lucky one?
Yeah. Okay. How'd I forget how to play?
First you jump, then you die. Pretty good. In a strange way, the wind helps.
In this level, yeah. Taking no chances. No! Uh-oh. Chance. Here you go.
So if you guys are... Right here. I will do a thing. Just so we know, just so we don't know that it's working.
5, 2, 3.
It seems like it should work, but...
Five, two, three.
Just so we know it's working.
Dark Link showed up in the Temple of Time a few times, and an Arwing appeared in Ganon's tower.
Alright, so all of the mistakes and stuff in RAM will still be happening.
Okay.
Yep.
Oh, working?
Yeah.
Down there.
It's gonna stay stuck there now.
Down in that corner by that bomb, it says death. That was Mado's test. Nope. Do a bunch of crazies.
All right, do a bunch of crazies.
5, 2, 5.
All right. All right. 5, 2, 5.
Yeah.
Where is it?
There. I want to read these.
This works. It might crash because I don't know Lua very well at the moment.
I wanted to read your code. Oh, it crashed.
Oh, wait. It has to go here.
Aha! I learned something.
Alright. Alright, now here we go.
Okay.
I might stutter the game when I die. So right now I have it do 25 corruptions every time I die. Now we're just trying to get me dead, huh?
Yeah.
But I'm trying to actually beat it.
Hundred corruptions.
Hundreds? Okay.
No, not yet. I don't know what corrupt RAM looks like.
For most of the part, you won't know things. Like, you won't notice.
Okay.
Oh! Speaking of which.
Huh. Well.
As you look away.
This is fun. Now I'm happy.
Oh.
It's gonna change again, isn't it? Yeah. Blaze War says this looks normal.
I thought I would stay, but I guess it just reset.
Hello, Stardust Lifestyle. You just missed really weird.
We're breaking the game because it's broken us. So, like I said, probably next week we're going to be doing more Mario Collection, probably the Mario 3 side of things soon. And then so Tony can help, like, make the Mario RPG hacky thing look nice and happy.
Yeah.
Right now it looks like something I designed.
And Mario 3 is cool and fun.
We're going to try to do every stage. Also, I'm not very good at it.
Never done that. I'm Luigi. Okay.
Luigi?
Yeah.
His name is Frank.
No, his name's Tony. Mario's Frank.
There we go. Barely going.
Game Genie background was appropriate.
yeah. Basically, I'm doing what I did as a kid, just making the game do new things. I had a lot of fun making Game Genie codes as a kid.
No, Tony doesn't program. He, he'll graphic it up all pretty and made a little... program it.
So someone on Reddit the other day was like, I can't believe it. The Legends of Localization site still looks like it's from 2005 when the books look so great. And I think it's because I designed the site and yeah. Tony designed the books. If you've seen me do art before, it all makes sense.
I still design websites like as if it was 2000 because that's when I learned how. I was on Firefox for 1 second, and it had this thing like, this is what CSS whatever looks like, blah, 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 I don't know. I was like, what?
Once I, like, actually learned CSS, things made a lot more sense.
Mm-hmm.
Just websites make so much more sense after I learned that in jQuery.
I had to learn, I don't know if it was CSS, PHP. Is that still a thing?
Yeah. But I didn't know you knew PHP.
Yeah, because Emilio programmed my website. Like, he designed and programmed it. And I learned best by, like...
copying...
looking at the source code and, like, changing things around and seeing what does what.
Yeah, welcome to being a programmer.
So, I learned how to do PHP through Emilio's work on my site, which I don't update anymore because... whatever, it's an old website. CSS Lewis. Lucklight wants an LOL version that looks like a 1980s terminal.
Oh. Alright, game. I'm counting on you to do some weird stuff. Are we still doing 20? 25? Do you want to go to 100?
What are you talking about? Oh yeah, we're still doing 25. Let's go to 100. 535.
Alright.
Yeah, where'd the GeoCities web rings go? True, there's not enough text on our webpage for it to be a Japanese webpage. The game gets corrupted into being English. Meow, meow.
Get out of here.
Lucky 2 is dead now. That thing.
Oh, it happened again.
Yeah! I like that the castle's like got purple outlines. Hey, Bowser. What's up?
This is his wind, isn't it?
Oh, that was weird. You weren't able to see it. The Lakitu threw the spiny in between the question mark and the one thing, and it immediately turned into a spiny. Oh, the castle ended.
Oh, crap. No!
It's pretty distracting background. Ah, we're back. Welcome to the Cocoa Krispies level. Cocoa Pebbles. Okay. Who in this chat only knows the Flintstones from the cereal boxes?
Or the vitamins.
Or the vitamins.
My dad used to say that he would watch it as a kid, the Flintstones.
Mm-hmm.
And they had like smoking ads and things like that. And at the time, I didn't believe them. But then with like YouTube and stuff,
yeah, you can finally see it. You can see the Flintstones smoking. Oh my god. I only know the Flintstones from the WWE movie. So Lucklight knows him from the vitamins. Bahamut has watched the cartoon and the movie. Wang Fo, I have actually watched the show, much to my chagrin. Yeah.
It's okay, I liked it better than Jetsons.
No, I liked the Jetsons better.
Jetsons were too snooty.
Oh. Well, I liked the, like, flying around stuff.
I mean, that stuff's cool, yeah. The characters were really snooty and annoying.
Really?
And the future was stupid.
Wow.
Maybe because we already lived in the future. Oh.
Cartoon Network used to play reruns of the Flintstones all the time. You know, one thing that always confused me was Looney Tunes cartoons. And why they all use that really old style phone. Like, you put it to your ear and you ring like that. Because I thought everything was made today. Everything is made now. Not in the 1940s. Yeah. Like, the 1940s were not a concept in my head. So, that was cool when I found out the Looney Tunes are very old. Like, my dad used to watch them. My dad, learned English from watching cartoons.
Oh. I get punished for doing something good. I remember watching lots of Looney Tunes as a kid. And then never really having time to watch any, you know, since being a little kid. I feel like it'd be nice to just watch a bunch of them.
Looney Tunes?
Yeah.
Don't watch the really old ones when Bug Buzzy.
Yeah, that was his name back then.
When Bugs Bunny is like a jerk ass. Man. When that one episode where he meets Elmer Fudd and he's like, I can't live here eating this salad and this carrots. What is this? I need real food. And like he pretends to drown. He's a jerk.
Mm.
The old Bugs Bunny. My favorite Looney Tunes cartoons, let's see. The 90s had like a Looney Tunes resurgence. There was like Looney Space Tunes Jam. Clothes. Oh, right. I forgot. I like Roadrunner.
Oh.
My coworkers at Radio Shack learned English from Sex in the City from Ukraine. Oh, Lord.
Wow, I bet that was some interesting vocab.
Bug Bubsy. Bugs has been around since, like, the 30s.
Oh, I knew that was going to happen.
Dare I mention the gritty reboot comic? I hear it was written by a guy who hates the Flintstones, and judging by the reactions, it turned out way better than it had any right to.
There was a Jetsons-Flintstones crossover, I remember.
Yeah, Jetsons meet sister, the Flintstones.
My sister used to rent it all the time, yeah.
True, barely no corruptions.
Well, I can up it up and... Well, alright, I'll do even more. Alright.
545.
Alright.
I also like Daffy Duck. It was very 500.
Let's see, where's crazy stuff?
Oh my god.
Alright. Well, if I change that number, that'll make things go crazy. So we can try that as a last resort.
Okay. The House of 1,000 Corruptions. Like, Sylvester and Tweety were really popular in the 90s, but I didn't like them. Because it was the same story.
I thought I had died there.
I thought I told Brody Tat.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, yeah.
I did.
Yeah. Like, yeah, the road or the
Roadrunner. I like Roadrunner.
The Wile E. Coyote is always chasing the Roadrunner, but he does different things every episode. When I saw I thought Roadrunners were made up.
Mm-hmm.
I saw one in real life. I saw one in the Walmart parking lot, actually. And I was like, well, there's a Roadrunner.
Yeah, they're cool.
You know, you live in the desert. Yeah, they're really neat.
Their names make sense.
Yeah, you can tell it's a Roadrunner because it's always running. Can it fly?
I don't know. Probably not. It can probably, like...
How many corruptions are we at? 500?
500 per death. And across more of RAM. Through all of standard RAM. Uh-oh. Where am I?
I wasn't too big of a fan of the Muppets, but I liked Muppet Babies.
Yeah, the Muppets just felt a little too old for me for some reason. Oh no! I could have defeated this level. Oh, that was neat.
It turned pink. Oh.
Something happened. You saw it.
Yeah, I saw it.
I did.
I did taw it turn pink.
Oh.
But did it meep meep? Hmm.
No.
Oh. We're getting into the danger zone.
Oh. By the way, it could affect my life count too, if it felt like it.
It could.
Yeah. Oh. Oh, that was neat.
Could the ROM be curing the corruptions as they happen?
Yeah, it's like refreshing RAM, you know, as it's like switching to the new screen. That's likely why it wasn't doing a whole lot of stuff.
Oh yeah, I love the Animaniacs.
Uh-oh.
Wasn't Tiny Toon Adventures... like...
I remember when that was announced. Oh god, that makes me old. I saw it announced in TV Guide.
Ah! You old. I'm married to an old.
Guess what? You're getting ever closer to being one.
Oh! Could it overflow the life count?
Yeah. That happened one time we got game over.
Yep. Today we learned the Lost Levels is extremely well coded and can function with 90% of its RAM corrupted.
It reminds me of that part of that really early Simpsons where the doll was trying to kill Homer. And I was like, oh, this is the problem. It's set to evil. That's what I get the feeling.
Oh.
I feel like this game is set to evil. I'm trying to set it to good.
And then he flips the switch. Yeah. I love you.
Yep. And then he's like in the Barbie house or whatever.
TV Guide. You are old. We have a TV Guide. We bought it.
Yep. It has like
video games.
Like recommendations for the latest 81 video games.
The latest Atari games.
Yeah. Not even just Atari. Whoa.
Oh my god. I had a frightening realization that I am not older than most, if not all, of the actors of the original Star Trek at the time they were on the show.
Yeah, it's weird to look back and see, like, oh, this person became, you know, president, or this person, like, took over a country at this age, you know?
No, never.
I'm right around there.
Never think that. Like, Prince got an Oscar when he was 25. That doesn't mean anything to your life.
The thing that makes me feel the oldest is, like, all this entertainment that I translate. Every year, I feel less and less connected to it.
Huh.
I can relate to it less and less.
Yeah.
Even though it's all about, like, you know, 13-year-olds in junior high or something.
Mm-hmm.
And I just feel less and less connected to it. I'm like, these are the dumbest problems to have.
Every day is kite day on Anime Town.
Yeah.
In Anime Town.
Also, their clothes just get stupider. I think that's even a big sign of me getting old. No.
Oh my god, the wisdom of the bar got you.
I didn't know there was a fire on that chocolate bar. Oops. 555, 556. Let's do that. When we make a movie, let's have 556 something.
When that movie, what's that movie where Morgan Freeman was God?
Bruce Almighty, was it?
Okay, yeah. Was it? Probably. They had, like, you know, he had God's phone number that Bruce...
Oh, I don't remember the story, so well, that's news to me.
He could call God, and it was a real phone number. It wasn't 555. And so this lady lived somewhere, I don't know, New Jersey or something, and that was her phone number.
No.
Like, it didn't have an area code, but, like, it just happened to work for her. And so kids would call her and ask to talk to, like, their grandma up in heaven and stuff. No. And she was like, oh, this is awful. And they changed it on the DVD release to 555.
Oh.
Yep. Okay, Bruce Almighty.
Wow, what's going on with these corruptions?
Tommy Two Tone, I guess, who sang the song 857-5309, got that number banned in most districts. There's also that song, I think, by The Time.
Oh, no.
Called 777-9311. Oh. Remember long distance phone calls?
Yeah, is that still a thing?
Nope. Thank goodness. I saw the pink again. Yeah. We need to corrupt this more. 560.
Oops, wrong one. 560. All right. Here we go. We're going to do this. I think. Oh, no, I don't know. I don't know if I programmed that right, but 560?
Yeah.
This might not work. This might crash the game. Or it might make it good.
The sound sounds lower.
Wonder once under there, can you put the basket there? Mm-hmm. Maybe we're messing with the RAM from the other games. It's like if you were to go play Mario 3, it'd just be crazy. Although it'd probably initialize.
She wants to nap.
Ooh, 25 follows. Uh-oh. Oh! Alright. Let's see if this breaks the game.
Well, we'll always have the memory of weird castle wind.
Yeah. Well, I haven't given up yet. I looked away for a second, and that's what happens. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
562?
62, yeah.
All right. I don't think I've programmed that. Alright, so this might stutter the game when I die.
Fine. It'll still work, right?
Yeah. But as we're doing it, I'm getting better at the level, so it's not too bad.
That's the only goal. Oh. corrupt the tile maps and random new blocks can show up.
Oh. I'm gonna guess that every time it loads this up, it reinitializes a bunch of stuff, so...
Now Wonka's saying, I imagine the problem is that it's only... This is only using as much RAM as the NES game, and therefore harder to actually hit a usable piece of RAM.
Yeah.
Hmm. Eight people followed. Here's a little spiny man. He is walking off a cliff. He's dumb. Jump on that springboard. We want to see a windy castle. Where is the windy castle?
I was hoping I could make that.
Was Locky 2 supposed to be there?
I don't know. Oh, no.
Oh, wanders down.
What's she doing?
I don't know.
Oh, she's over there.
Oh.
She's looking for the secret cat.
We have a cat who comes by our window at night and just stares at our own cats.
It's creepy.
We named it Apophis.
Because did we decide on that?
Well, because it always comes back. Until that one time where King Darien, don't listen.
He doesn't come back.
He was destroyed by the replicators.
Well, assumedly.
Apparently. He watched episode 1 of Stargate SG-1 yesterday. And he's like, should I like rewatch the movie or something? Mm. I'm like, no.
Episode 1?
Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, it gets good after like episode 6.
Yeah, I'm like... Keep watching. I actually said episode 3.
Yeah, episode 3 I think is that dumb one.
Episode 3 is the really stupid one, and then it immediately picks up.
They go to, like, the world where, what is it, Shang Tsung from the Mortal Kombat movie is the leader of a village. I can never take him seriously whenever he's in anything.
Yeah. A planet episode with a really primitive society, and they're boring, and they have boring problems. Yeah, Bahamut, that is so true. Carter starts super bad and gets a lot better quickly.
I got time up.
Yes.
That's exactly what happened.
We're already on season 9 in St. Ostrich. We're upset with the changes. But, you know, whatever. We have the entire 10-season DVD set. We're going through it. We might have another Stargate fan at Fangamer soon.
Stargamer?
Stargamer. You think that Stargate Super Nintendo game is any good?
No. Looks like a licensed game.
What would they have renamed the show?
Is it me or is the wind got stronger? It feels like it's gotten stronger to me.
Now Wong says, it's weird watching SG-1 and then seeing a place on an alien planet that I have been to.
Really?
Where do they film their alien planet episodes that you've been to?
Well, you know, they're like with buildings, like that one that looks like a big ol' presidential library or something, the Tolan world, stuff like that. Renalwonk works Cheyenne Mountain.
Oh, they shot in Vancouver. Not Cheyenne Mountain Complex in Colorado.
Oh.
Stargate Super Nintendo game is awful.
Remember when I was doing so good when we started the stream? I was like, whoa, I'm so good at this game. What happened? Am I me? Alright, we're at 572.
Bahamut, that's no worse than... I don't even want to repeat what Colonel O'Neill said when he was on that planet with all the Lady Jaffa. Mato's doing some hacking.
Wait, what was it?
I don't want to say.
72?
70... Yeah, let's go 72. 75?
I don't remember how many deaths I had.
What are we doing here? I've just been talking about Stargate and spacing
out. Probably be fewer graphical glitches, but more crazy glitches, possibly. Oops.
Whoop.
Oh, never mind.
Yeah! My favorite! This is some Cocoa Ash Krispies.
This is post-volcano.
Yes. The volcano exploded. That one episode that takes place in the future, and they have this futuristic space airport where the Stargate is, and it's actually just like a place in Vancouver. That must kill the magic now really badly.
The heck was that?
I don't know.
Oh, you know what? I think the cat is trying to get under the garbage can.
What?
It's because there's a food.
It is,
this is
getting really windy.
I don't know. Ghosts? Uh-oh. I like this place. I need a screenshot of that. Oh!
Ah, I kicked the bottle!
Uh-oh. Now we're getting good.
Aww. Why does it say World C2?
Oh, crap. I don't know.
Hello, NK.
We're playing the really lost levels. Oh no.
Are you sure this is C2 or is this just C3 and it's called C2?
We have one life left, Poe.
What? I didn't see that part. What happened to all those lives we got? No. Oh.
I don't like how you can't see your lives. I'm gonna complain to Nintendo. So you were back at C3.
Good. Is this even the correct music for this game?
I don't know. Should I just redo it?
Yeah.
Oh, that was weird. I'm not gonna make that.
That was the final boss music.
Oh, oh
what?
I'm in 2-3. Oh, crap, I'm in 2-3.
Oh, you are.
Of 1, I think.
Of Mario 1?
No, this is not 1.
No!
I don't know where I am anymore.
We're never gonna beat the game if you keep doing this. Yeah, this is 2. This. Well, what? Oh,
it's... There's checkpoints. It must be glitched.
I thought it had... No.
I'm just so used to not having that anymore.
You want to corrupt it? You got corrupted.
Gotta go back. Nintendo's punishing me. All these extra lives are gonna go away in a second because we have to go back.
Well.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I've done this level so many times. Well, I'm glad I did this because otherwise this would be really aggravating.
The weird
this gives
stuff?
Us, this gives us something to look forward to. I mean, the levels really. Let's see if it.
We have to go back to 1985.
So we got the chat followers helping us as we fight the system.
Oh, burn. Yeah, we're still in C3 though. It's good.
Oh, you cloud creature.
Oh. Oh. Yeah.
Oh.
Aww.
That was neat, whatever that was. Uh-oh, what the heck?
Your time is not going down. Well...
Oh, well, I was Luigi for a second.
It wasn't. Oh, thanks, Luigi. You're Luigi again.
All right.
And your time is stuck.
Oh, man, my... I'm so used to playing as Mario, so it's going to be hard.
Or easier?
I don't know if the lives are going to affect Luigi, though. I didn't really test it with Luigi. Oh, I thought I was going to die there.
Still got Lucky Luigi.
Oh, yeah, that jump's a little different with Luigi.
Yeah, look at our score when you can.
Oh, that was doing, I was doing pretty well there.
Oh.
This is like what we get for hacking it. This is like the anti-hacking song.
Yeah. We've caught you, hacking.
Yeah, we caught you. Lockatoo. Like, even without the Lockatoo, this would be pretty much close to the same difficulty.
Yeah. He's easy to avoid. That's Miyamoto on the other side wagging his finger at you. You should have said the magic word.
Mario.
You shouldn't have hacked my game.
Oh
no!
I was getting, I was trying to be too careful there. Oh! Oh! Oh crap! This is Kaizo Mario.
Oops.
Uh oh.
We're back at B1.
I'm at Luigi, but I'm Mario. Didn't I do this already today?
Yeah.
To this very day?
Yes.
On my first try to this level, I think.
Yeah.
Oh, and I couldn't get that. It's Red Luigi.
It just gave up.
I'm controlling it somehow.
Hmm. It's like how that guy died in,
It happened again.
IT Crowd. Where he just jumped out the window.
Oh, yeah. Get out of there, Cooper. Hanging with Buster Koopa.
Cooper Duper.
So, maybe we'll just keep doing this until I finally do beat the game.
What do you mean?
Because this makes it better.
The corruption?
Yeah.
We can't even get... Well, no, I guess if you make a new save state each level, in case it gets too corrupted.
Yeah.
Okay.
And if I have to, I'll do some intricate hacking to get to the stage I need to be at.
Oh, no, you're not allowed.
Oh. Underwear.
Still on C3.
Getting out of there.
What do you think Lakitu's favorite food is?
Is that quote stuck? I haven't been paying attention.
Don't think so.
Some garbage over there. Lakitu's favorite food?
Yeah.
Angel's food.
Angel food cake?
Yeah.
I haven't had that in so long.
That's the kind you have with strawberries, right? Strawberries?
Sponge cake.
Oh, okay. Because at the supermarket, they have a big old loaf of the angel food cake next to strawberries. We're in the castle town.
It's my favorite. This is Volcano mm-hmm. Castle.
I feel like more confident when I'm here. It's so weird that one single background can do that. I like it when it gets to the crazy at the end of here, though. Nope. Get out of here. Okay.
Do you think Lakitu likes slushies? No!
I was getting to my favorite area.
Oh.
Getting to my hometown over there. Uh-oh.
Time stopped and you can't move.
Yeah, it's... Everything is stuck. The music's going, though. That's weird. It let me go for a while.
Cotton candy. Clearly Lakitu's favorite candy.
Whoa, that was evil.
It's the Spike Lobby.
Yep. I just got to the episode where they introduced how the Spike Lobby was created. That was good.
Oh boy, I forgot. What was it again?
It was about the Pirate Treasure episode.
The ship?
Where, like, there's an actual pirate treasure was found in a ship that was in the middle of a desert.
Oh!
No.
Thank you, OmniGamer. We don't got this. And we're corrupting the RAM every time Mado dies.
It makes it better.
Meow, 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 meow.
This is how every child should play this on the Famicom Disk System.
Andrew Ray, that joke. Oh.
What? If I beat this, will it count?
I don't know, because it still says C3.
It's this crappy level again.
But it says C3.
Yeah, so I wonder if I beat it, if it will think. Oh, I hate that level. Go away.
to try it. Alec wanted you to beat it.
No, I gotta beat it legit.
That was level C-3PO. Can we weather all of these cloud puns?
This reminds me of Ninja Gaiden 2. When they were like, what else can we do to the gameplay? Oh, just to have something move. Oh.
It's really, really windy out there.
Yeah, that's why we're getting the wind level. No. I'm getting good at that.
Oh, Luigi's here on C2.
All right. No, now he's not.
If we accidentally...
Oh, I'm used to Mario's jump there.
Can I be Luigi? Yeah.
All right, Poe.
Oh, wait. Okay, I don't even know who this is.
Yes. Cool. Oh, yeah.
Get a picture of me jumping.
All right.
Oh, no. Look at that. I'm turning around.
Jump. There you go. Well, let's see what these other guys are, if anything. Oh, they're the same.
Turtle!
I like how it's like actually makes sense to call it a player.
Yeah. Heck yeah.
You're still... Oh, but you're in C2 now.
I got some good luck.
Luigi is a player.
No, I feel like he jumps like Mario.
So, here's your new Halloween costume, everyone.
I feel like invincible, like I could hit him and nothing would happen, but I just...
The end. You want to end it here?
Yeah.
All right, so we'll end it here, and we'll probably pick this up on Monday. Same with corruption and everything. Okay. Until we can beat this level.
We can't beat it!
It's more fun this way, anyway. Alright, so see you guys Monday. Anything going on Monday? We can still stream Monday, right?
What's Monday? May 1st.
See you on May 1st.
See you May the 1st be with you.
At what time?
5 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Eastern. We're going to keep playing this, and maybe next week we'll play Mario 3, hopefully.
Yep. See you guys Monday.
See you Monday.
Bye-bye. Here, I'll just leave the music on for you guys.
But you have to save these deaths.
Oh, yeah. All right, now I'll turn off the music. Okay, bye, guys.
Bye.